How everybody doing today? Everybody good? That's good. That's good. So first of all, it's hot as hell out here today, so we are not doing too much at all. I just want to go in here, check my watermelons, make sure none of them are bust open that I may be able to eat. I want to check on my corn that I planted. I want to check on my radishes that I planted, my turnip greens. And then I want to put these tomato cages that I just bought around my tomatoes to get those off the ground. I only have three left that I need to get off the ground as of right now before they start putting out their tomatoes. And then that's all I'm doing today. Like I said, it's hot out here. I don't really need to be doing anything in the garden. We got a heat wave that's going to end roughly about Wednesday here in Virginia. So all the work I need to do, I can wait until next weekend. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and get this stuff done. Boy, where the hell you little niggas come from? That one just hatched out. Boy, fresh over here doodling. Well, we got some more chickens on the phone. Get your ass out the way, Mother Goose, so I can see you. Fat booty ass chicken. All right, y'all, so I wasn't gonna put this on video because I just started eating it, but this is one of my golden goals. As you can see, it's pretty small. There's like four of them like this, and then I have two that are about double to triple this size. I already nibbled into it to taste it, and it's definitely ripe. And I will have to say, I like this one more than the orange glow that I grew last year. Like, the orange glow has like a very, very mild citrus flavor to it. This one doesn't, but the texture is tighter. This is like a red, but at the same time, it does. It's, I don't know, but I will say, as of now, this is probably my favorite watermelon. You know, out of all red, orange, or you know, a golden gold, I'm gonna have to say this one for now. And this isn't cold at all. It's still warm, very warm. But this is a very good watermelon. Very good. Like literally like a lemon, but it doesn't have any type of citrus type flavor to it that I can tell. I said, beside it being small, that's the only thing. But I'm sure if I grow these earlier, like start them in my basement, and get a jump on the season, I'm sure, you know, a nice dose of fertilizer, more than I did this year. Now, this is a mukbang right here. This is what I'm talking about right here, baby. This type of mukbang don't give you no big ass back. It's that healthy mukbang right here, baby. And you can see I got a bunch of seeds that I can already keep. I done took probably 10 out already, but there's a bunch in there. These will be grown on this farm for the rest of my life. I don't know, like, when I have kids, if they'll like it as much as I do, but this is gonna be a Ferris Farm special right here. In the future, when I get my house built up and the farm, you know, plotted out how I want it, I will be selling these. So be on the lookout for that. And we got a book coming too, but don't tell nobody. Tell me why I ordered these shits off Amazon. I gotta put this shit together. I thought these was all folded up in the box.
Yeah,
somebody come help me, man.
Yeah, they can't walk like me, nigga. Smile like me or nothing, nigga. I be mad too. See, I'm that nigga. I'm that one that waited on my snap, then cropped no picture. I'm the one they live for dead, but now they like my pictures. I'm that young nigga, they changed it on, cause I got richer. I'm the one that gon' just speak my mind, but don't got filter. Bitch, I'm never solo. Bitch, I got my mojo. Maybe permanent door closed. Every car I got horses in it, but not polo. AP look like snow cones. Beats me now, he smoked on. Track out truck, my door's gone. Solid bitch, no clothes on. You can't keep it solid with B, dude, then get your roll on.
Alright, so as y'all can see, that little project right there got your boy out here sweating. But everything in the garden looks good. I already got corn jumping up.
I got my radishes jumping up, and I got my turnip greens jumping up. So like I said, I'm not staying out this heat today. Really no point. Everything in the garden is good. Watermelons are good. I did get a nice yellow watermelon. So everything's good. The tomatoes are jumping back fully. Let me show y'all what things looking like. So you got the radishes jumping up easy. When they get bigger, you know, and the temperatures cool down, I'll separate those and put them in a nice rows. When I take the Swiss chard up, I'm put some through the air, put new Swiss chard down, all that good stuff. Same with the turnip greens. When they get to a nice size and it cools down, I'll spread them out evenly, mulch them, all that good stuff. These tomato cages are actually really good, really sturdy, compared to the ones with the three legs on it. So I'll probably actually get me a bunch more of these and start using these from now on. It's PVC piping. And as you can see, these tomatoes are really starting to jump up. They should be good in about 2 weeks and finally give me a good old tomato. But with that being said, I'm about to take my ass inside. It's hot as hell out here. I'll wait till next weekend when this heat wave gone. With that being said, y'all be easy. Boy, where the hell you little niggas come from? That one just hatched out. Boy, fresh. Oh, yeah, doodle one. We got some more chickens on the phone. Get your ass out the way, Mother Goose, so I can see you. Fat booty ass chicken. You ain't been coming out the coop too much, Mother Goose, so go ahead and get yourself nice and hydrated. Get your babies nice and hydrated too.